real friend of mine, and also a former nerd. A good buddy, a laborer with Christ, and a rock and roll brother, Mr. Steve Camp. Well, it's great to be here in Pottstown. Pottstown. Oh, no. Okay. Remember, I'm family, all right? It ain't rock and roll as it feeds back on you. Socket. That's why my hair looks like this tonight. Oh. about the Lord Jesus Christ, and it's good to know that the generation is going down the tubes real quick, that we have a solid rock to turn to in Jesus. Isn't that true? The headlines don't look so good. I realize that. The newspapers, the headlines don't look so good, but I just wish that once that they would print that nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. It might give them some hope today. John, are you getting this mic out there, man? No. Under his love, we're convicted but forgiven. Under his love, we somehow pass the test. Often, sir, it has no time for my feelings, but under his love is where under his love, he takes me through my struggles. He guides my life as he watches over me. Now long ago, you know, I felt so trapped and lonely. But under his love, I finally been set free. And when I stray away, his spirit haunts me. He brings me back. I'm so glad to know my Lord still loves this key. And when I stray away, his spirit haunts me. He brings me back. I'm so glad to know my Lord still loves me. Under his love, he takes me through my sorrows. I found my place. I have no desire to roam. Skies, for he may come back tomorrow, and if he does, are you ready to go home? Under his love is where I find my rest. Under his love, oh, I've finally been set free. Under his love, you know I'm ready. Oh, this boy is so ready to go home. Already paid. He's gonna gather up his followers and steal us all away. He's a little bit of a night, you'll sweep down on the sure Carl Sagan must know. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, how can he get paid for doing something like this, right? He's another dinner by now, and he's coming back to take you out home. He's another dinner by now, for he has. Thank you. may be mighty, but our Lord Jesus Christ is almighty. Is that right? And he said that he's going to build a church and the gates of hell shall not stand against it. This song is called Upon This Rock. Upon this rock I will build my church and the gates of hell. Chicago, excuse me, I was up in Canada a couple years ago and with a very somber, mellow group of guys, very humble and full of humility, guys from Chicago called the Resurrection Band. When I was there, I had a chance to sing with them, and after one of the concerts, they brought it to me after this concert at Hell's Angel. And this guy was about this wide, you know, about this high. And I went on over to him. I said, "Hi, what's your name?" And he looks at me and he goes, "Tiny." And I didn't know how to handle it. But what happened was he pulled out a knife about that long and put it to my chest. He said, "Man, I'm going to kill you." I said, why are you uptight tonight? And I said, is it my breath or my singing? I had no idea, you know, what does to people sometimes. And turned out he had a little cross hanging in his ear, hanging upside down. And I thought, maybe this might have something to do with it. And I said, Tiny, what does that cross mean to you? And he said, it means I hate Jesus, but I love Satan. And I knew right then that my battle was not with Tiny, right? Because the Bible says I did not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the powers of this dark world. And I also knew that greater is he that's in me than he that's in this world, right? And so what happened was I started praying, and Tiny, much to my delight, put down the knife. And this little lady, about 82 years young, came on over and put her arms around him. And I want you to know, 2 hours later, this guy got on his knees and accepted Jesus Christ. Is too hard for our Lord Jesus Christ, right? I don't care if you may be a pastor or a prostitute, Jesus died for you and loves you and can change your life. And second thing, folks, if an 82-year-old woman can go to a res band show, there is no generation gap. haven't sung it for a very long time, but a good friend of mine, Larry Norman, wrote it. We've all been through a lot of changes, I think, in the last few years. I know I have. And the thing that the Lord has been doing the most with me is he's been breaking me before he's been blessing me. He's been crushing me before he's been crowning me. And he wants me to know and convince the reality of a Calvary in my life before I ever know the outpouring of Pentecost. See, it costs something to follow the Lord. And today in this country, we're giving people... Someone shoot that down, will you? And it costs something to follow Jesus. And I want you to know that with the election and all that we've had go down this last couple weeks here, a lot of important decisions have been made. Religion has been a issue this year, a political issue. Okay, can we have a healing service for that guy? I gotta tell you. Christ, I just want you to know it's not a political issue. He's God. And he's not easy propaganda that we hand out on the street corners. His life demands that we live the truth, not just hand leaflets out for him. It's easy to raise your hands. It's easy to clap here tonight and get excited about the Lord. A good pastor friend of mine told me, he says, you know, when Christians all get together in one big pile, they're like manure. They stink. He said, but if we're spread out over our towns and our cities, we can act as a real good fertilizer. So I hope you're fertilizing Pottstown for Jesus Christ. I hope you go away from here tonight, not just with some good entertainment, but I hope you go away realizing that you can make a difference in your town for the Lord. And I grew up in the shadows of your silos filled with grain, but you never helped to fill my empty spoon. You killed a black man at midnight just for talking to your daughter, and you make his wife your mistress and you leave her without water. And the sheet you wear upon your face is the sheet your children sleep on. And at every meal they say a prayer they don't believe, but still they keep on. And your money says you don't be trusted, but it's against the laws to bring to school. You say we beat the Russians to the moon, and I say starve your children to do it. We are far across the ocean in a war that's not our own. And while we're winning theirs, we're gonna lose the one at home. The politicians all make speeches, and the newsmen all take notes, and they exaggerate the issues as they shove it down our throats. And your money says in God we trust, but it's against the laws to pray in school. You see, we beat the Russians to the moon, and I see the starve your children. It's important for us as Christians to speak out on issues, and I'm glad that we're heading into issues such as Central America, Nicaragua, abortion, and so forth. War is an ugly thing, but I want you to know there's a spiritual warfare going on around us right now that a lot of people are oblivious to. And instead of just taking a human life, they're capturing human souls, and hell is too populated already.
Man.
And I hope people get out and take this message of Jesus Christ to the people that need to hear it. I want to ask yourself a question. What was the last time you witnessed to somebody? What was the last time you let somebody get close enough to your life to feel your heartbeat? And to realize that your heartbeat is linked to Jesus. We're so comfortable and complacent in this country. We're so over-Christianized and so familiar with spiritual things that we've become dormant spiritually. And your money says in God we trust, but it's against the laws to pray in school. Say you beat the Russians to the moon, and I see you starve your children to do it. You say all men are evil.